Hi, I'm Fazzy, and today I will be showing you how to optimize and prepare your VRoid model for VRChat using VRoid Studio and Blender. The most basic way to upload a VRoid model to VRChat is by using the UniVRM converter in Unity. This may be the fastest way, but VRoid models uploaded in this way is very unoptimized. The model can have 15 up to 20 or more
materials
and a lot of unnecessary polygons and bones. This tutorial is to help you make your VRoid avatar more PC friendly and have a better avatar performance ranking. We will be using VRoid Studio and Blender to optimize our
materials,
polygons and bones. Bear in mind that you can actually do all the optimization techniques using VRoid Studio in Blender, so you can skip the VRoid Studio section. But it is useful to know how to use the optimization tools in VRoid Studio too. They all work more or less the same way as in Blender, but to a lesser degree. So, let's begin. To optimize your model in VRoid Studio, go to the Camera/Export tab and click Export. You can view information about your model in Export Info. Currently, this model has 32,000 something polygons. Firstly, check the Delete Transparent Meshes checkbox. This will delete all the meshes that has transparency and greatly reduce polygon count. I highly recommend you to do this in VRoid Studio. The sliders in the Polygon Reduction tool works the same way as Decimate in Blender, but is less powerful. Reduce the polygon count in the mesh by adjusting the sliders. You can drag the sliders or click at random points to change the value. If you reduce the polygons too much, it will greatly deform the mesh and make it look bad. So, play around with the sliders a bit to get the best value for the mesh. Find a balance between polygon reduction and retaining your mesh enough so that the model looks good. It is not necessary to decimate the body or face mesh since you want your face to look good, and we can delete unnecessary parts of the body mesh by leaving the hidden parts transparent or by deleting the mesh later in Blender. If you do not have tails or wings, check the Combine Hair Mesh checkbox. The Material Reduction tool works the same way as atlasing materials in Blender, but you have more freedom in Blender as to which materials to combine. You can choose to reduce your texture quality by changing this option to shrink, although I haven't noticed any differences in my experience using this. I will leave the bones and materials as is because I will do this in Blender. Once you are done, export the model. We will combine the textures, reduce bone count, reduce the polygons even more, and prepare the model for VRChat in Blender. If this is your first time using it, I will show you how to download Blender and set it up for VRChat. If you already have Blender and the Cats Blender plugin installed, you can skip this section. To set up Blender for VRChat avatar creation, we will need four things: Blender, the Cats Blender plugin, the VRM add-on, and the Material Combiner add-on. To make things easier, I suggest you create a new folder to store all these files. To download Blender, Google search Blender and select the download link. Go to Previous Versions, download every version of Blender, and scroll down to find Blender 2.83. Find Blender 2.83.7 and select the appropriate version for your operating system. Click to download. Next, download the Cats Blender plugin, the Material Combiner add-on, and the VRM add-on. Links are in the description below. Unzip the Blender file to your preferred location. Do not unzip the Cats plugin and other add-ons because we will install it in Blender as a zip file. Open Blender. You can double-click the .exe file or run it as administrator. Click anywhere on the screen to close this window. Expand this corner to view your tools. We do not have the Cats Blender tool yet. Go to Edit, Preferences, and click Install. Navigate to the folder where you saved the Cats plugins and add-ons. Install the Cats plugin first. Select the Cats plugin zip file and click Install add-on. After it has loaded, check it to enable the plugin. You should now be able to see the CATS plugin tool. If it says to update the plugin, click Update, OK, and restart the program. Now, we have to install the VRM add-on and the Material Combiner add-on. The CATS plugin will let you know which add-ons you are missing. We have already downloaded the add-ons that we need. Go to Edit, Preferences, Install, and select the VRM add-on. Repeat the same steps for the Material Combiner add-on. Now, Blender is ready for creating VRChat avatars. Create a new Blender file by going to File, New, General. Delete the default objects by pressing A to select everything and the X key to delete. Expand this arrow and select the CATS tool. Click the hamburger icon and select VRM. Find your VRM file and click Import VRM. Your imported model should look like this. Use the middle mouse button to pan and rotate. Click on this hand icon to move the view. You can use this widget to look from different viewpoints. As you can see, the model has many bones and has three separate meshes: body, face, and hair. Click the wrench icon and make sure that all these options are checked. Click OK, then click Fix Model. CATS will automatically combine your mesh and optimize your bones. All your meshes have been combined into one body mesh. We can see the number of polygons on this bottom right corner here. We still have 21,000 something polygons. We can reduce this further in Blender. Firstly, select your body mesh and click Tab to go into Edit mode. Toggle X-ray vision and click and drag over your model to select everything. Go to Faces and click Trace to Quads. This will reduce the number of faces, but it does not necessarily reduce the number of polygons on your model. Now, we will optimize our polygons further. Press Tab again to go to Object Mode and select the Body Mesh. You can also switch between Object and Edit Mode using this menu up here. Go to Model Options and click Materials. This will separate your combined mesh into different meshes separated by material. This way, you can edit the body mesh and hair meshes separately. The first thing we want to do is reduce polygons by deleting parts of the body mesh that is hidden under the clothes. Select your body mesh and press Tab to go into Edit mode. You will know that you are in Edit mode when you can see the mesh. Toggle your X-ray vision on. You can toggle the visibility of other meshes by clicking this eye icon. Hide the closed mesh. If the bones are too distracting, you can hide the visibility of the armature by clicking the eye icon. As you can see, a part of my boobs are missing. This is because I erased this part in my body texture so that my boobs wouldn't clip through my clothes. This is exactly what Delete Transparent Meshes does in VRoid Studio. It will delete any mesh that has transparency. So, you can actually already do this step in VRoid Studio by simply leaving parts of the body transparent. But if you didn't, you can do this in Blender too. Toggle the visibility of the closed mesh. Change the selection tool to Select Circle and hold Shift while selecting to select multiple vertices. You can even erase part of the head because it is hidden. If you accidentally select too much, hold Ctrl to deselect. Once your selection is done, press P and click Selection to create a new mesh from the selection. Delete this new mesh. Toggle the visibility of the closed mesh again, and you can see that the mesh you have selected is deleted. In case you miss some parts, you can simply go back to your body mesh and repeat the process. Because we have the X-ray vision on, it will select all the vertices in view. If you do not want this, toggle the X-ray vision off. This way, you won't select or deselect the wrong parts. Continue selecting and deleting the mesh until you are done. However, I recommend deleting unwanted meshes in VRoid Studio because it is neater to manipulate the mesh this way. We have reduced approximately 1,000 polygons. We can reduce this number further by decimating the hair meshes. Although we have done this in VRoid Studio, we can further reduce it in Blender. Whilst in Object mode, select a hair mesh and go to Modifier Properties. Add a modifier and select Decimate. Click Tab to go into Edit mode to see how the meshes look. This helps me double-check the shape of the hair mesh I am editing. Press Tab again to go to
Object mode
and adjust the ratio slider to decimate. This works similarly to the way the polygons reduction tool work in VRoid Studio. When decimating, make sure that you are in Object mode. You won't be able to see the changes in Edit mode. Find a balance between polygon reduction and retaining the mesh enough to look good. Once you are happy with the decimation, click Apply. I go through each of my hair meshes to see which I can decimate further. You don't have to do this for all your meshes. Just do them to the ones that you can. Usually, it's enough to just decimate the hair as they usually have a lot of polygons. I will leave the clothes and body meshes as is, as I have decimated them in VRoid Studio, and I am okay with how they look. If you want, you can decimate them as well. Once you are done, select all the meshes by holding Shift and selecting the top and bottom meshes. Go to Object and select Join. Make sure to rename this mesh to Body. If not, you will get an error when exporting the model. At this stage, you might want to check to make sure your blend shapes are working properly. While selecting the body mesh, go to the Object Detail Properties tab and go to the Shape Keys section. These are your blend shapes. Change the values to 1 to test the blend shape. It seems to be working fine. Make sure you reset each value to 0 just in case. Next, go to the Eye Tracking section to set eye tracking. Make sure your head and eye bones are assigned correctly. For blink left and blink right, assign the corresponding eye close blend shapes. Leave everything else as it is and click Create Eye Tracking. Sometimes you'll get an error after creating eye tracking. I'm not sure what it means, so I usually ignore it because it doesn't affect the model. The Start Testing button will appear. Check the up, down, and left-right motions to make sure they are working properly. Test the blinking by clicking the Test button next to Blink Strength. Click Reset Shapes to unblink. Click Stop Eye Testing once you're done. Next, we will create the visemes. This will create blend shapes for lip syncing. Assign blend shapes to the visemes that it most closely resemble. However, there is usually no blend shape to specifically correspond to viseme J. I usually assign either facial mouth E or facial mouth I to viseme J. Click Create Visemes. Now, we will atlas or combine our materials. Go to Optimization and select Atlas. Click Generate Material List and this will give you a list of all the materials on your model. If you want to check the textures individually, select your body mesh. Click Material Properties and select the material that you want to view. Click Preview and press XY Plane Render Type. You can see your individual textures this way. When atlasing materials, group together the materials that you will apply the same shader or effects to. I usually apply the same shader to all my materials, so I usually combine all the materials into one atlas. But for this model, I want to give the body, hair and clothes an outline to give it a more 2D effect. I do not want to give the eyes and other face details the same effect because it will look bad. So, I will combine them into different atlases. To make it easier, you can deselect all the materials first by clicking this icon at the top. To atlas materials, tick the materials that you want to combine. Before saving your atlas, save the Blender project file into its own folder so that your atlas will automatically be saved in the same project location. This helps with organization. Click Save Atlas to generate and save your atlas. Now, repeat the same steps to the other materials that you want to combine. I leave the face skin material on its own because I want to give it a different outline width. We have reduced the number of materials from 19 to 3. The next step is an extra step you can take to make sure that your model does not have the inwards knees bending issue in VRChat. This is caused by leg bones that are too straight. Select the armature and this will automatically bring you into edit mode. Click and drag over the knee joints to select both knee joints. Press 3 or use this widget to view it from the side. Press G to grab and drag the joint so that the knees is slightly bent. Left click to release. By doing this, it will tell the IK which direction to bend your knees when in a crouching position. This will prevent the inwards knees bending issue, especially if you are using male set animation pose in VRC SDK 2 or if you are exporting your avatar using VRC SDK 3. And that is all for optimizing your model. Click Export Model, change the path mode to copy, and make sure this icon is selected. This will make sure your textures are embedded in the FBX file. Click Export FBX. After you have exported your FBX model, imported it into Unity, and do all the steps to prepare it for VRChat, the stats should be good or much better compared to when exported using UniVRM Converter. This is the avatar stats before optimization and after optimization. Any model with combined meshes and materials will generally be a good model. Adding any dynamic bones will make the avatar's ranking range from medium to very poor. So, if you want to keep your avatar good, it is best to not give it any dynamic bones at all. I will show you how to import an optimized VRoid model into VRChat in another tutorial. There are some extra steps that you have to do to make your optimized VRoid avatar work because we will have to do all the steps that UniVRM Converter do for us manually. As you can see, the facial expressions with gestures don't work yet because we haven't set the animation for the facial expressions. The avatar exporting process is also slightly different for VRC SDK 2 and VRC SDK 3. I hope you found this tutorial helpful and happy optimizing. Bye bye.
Wait, give me a chance to try things. Give me a chance. Give me a chance. I don't know what to do. Stop. A new one.